What is a second line? A second line is when a band comes together and the people and they play this type of music that people just can't help themselves. You know what I'm saying? I mean, you get a feeling within your body and it goes to your feet, and everybody just come together in the streets. They hear that music and they're coming.
A second line is a celebration that started from the jazz funerals back in the day, and it's just a part of, you know, you had the first line including the grand marshal and the family after a jazz funeral, after a funeral, and then you had the second line, the people who were following behind the band and all of that. So it's just a carryover from, you know, traditional black part of culture.
Second line culture is New Orleans, and New Orleans is second line culture. This is something that we're born into. We die in it. When a person leaves this earth, lots of times they have second lines to celebrate that person's life. So this is something that we've been doing. Again, like I said, I started parading when I was some 3-4 years of age. So this is something we've been doing all our life. So second line culture is New Orleans.
You know, being from New Orleans, we embrace each other. We love each other. I mean, I've been all over the world, and it's nothing like New Orleans. The people in New Orleans, you could meet someone in New Orleans and you're at their house eating with all their family members, and you just met them.
Explain it to everybody exactly the real reason behind Associated Press Club. You know what I mean?
Right.
People think it's just all fun.
Right. Yeah, you know, that's one of the biggest things too. Everything got an origin and a backstory, and especially when it comes to New Orleans and how it relates to Africa and all of, you know, the community aspect of it. You look at the same thing, they still have similar stuff in Africa, like with community and village organizations. Like they say, it take a village, you know? We just took that same thing and it just got translated over here. Sidewalk steppers, if you don't know, you soon will find out. If you don't know where you've been, first of all, you've been under the rock. If you don't know about the Treme Sidewalk Steppers, which is the preeminent second line Associated Pleasure Club, second line club in New Orleans, kickoff event for a very, very tremendous celebration, tremendous weekend, some tremendous cultural celebration, and to help us kick this weekend off, I have the one and only Big Hollis. What's happening, baby?
What's up, King?
What's up, King?
King, you know, we're getting ready for a major weekend right here.
I'm home now. So it's us being together and representing a club that we've all been affiliated with since we was little guys.
I'm looking most forward to a celebration of New Orleans culture, rich, diverse, and just unique culture. It's so big in terms of black people across the globe. This Second Line Club is celebrating its 30th year next year. They have a lot of history, a lot of tradition. This is a carryover from the traditional second lines that started, you know, over a century ago. So being a part of it, being celebrated as king and having that honor is just huge.
Could have not been put together for not divine intervention. We all know each other, we all go back. We all have a relationship with the Sidewalk Steppers. Our guy, the king, is going down.
And it's a beautiful thing because at the end of the day, it's a celebration of culture.
Yes.
You know what I mean? It highlights what's important, the foundation of this great and wonderful city, the black people that made New Orleans what it is, that make New Orleans special. This is a quintessential part of that cultural celebration, you know. And again, when you start talking about second line culture, and I want to get a little bit into that and what that means to New Orleans and the history and all of that stuff. But when you start talking about second line culture, it's so unique to New Orleans. Like you can't go anywhere else in the United States and find something similar. But if you go outside of the country, back to Africa or the Caribbean, you see those same cultural elements that we know come from the origin, which is Africa. And New Orleans has just made that, just like anything else, it's just a gumbo of all these different influences. And the culmination of that is what we see when you see a second line. Think about that, man. Think about the cultural significance of having decades, centuries of black culture in one spot. And what's going to happen on Sunday is going to be a reflection of all of that history. That's amazing. Tell me about Sidewalk Steppers Club is essentially running up on 30 years. Tell me what you have seen from the evolution, like from when you first started seeing them parade to now.
Growth. We are no longer a neighborhood organization.
No.
We worldwide.
Man.
We worldwide from Trombone Shorty, Mona Sky Young.
Shout out to Trombone, shout out to Mona.
Kaleidoscope, BB Judy, The Brag.
Right. You know,
we followed in Treva Williams and The Great. It's showtime.
It's showtime for sure, man. It's special, man, because it's just unity, it's community, you know, it's appreciation of history, and it's passion. Mm-hmm. You know, passion for a city and passion for a culture that's just so unique.
Say shout out to the King and congrats to the King. Man, he a great dude. He's part of the culture already. He might not be from New Orleans, but he is New Orleans and he's been adopted to be a New Orleans. So welcome to King, welcome to the city, welcome to the big things that he gonna do for the city, and man, and welcome to the culture.
On behalf of Alliance Medical, we call this event to toast to King Darryl as he takes his reign this weekend. So we want all you guys to celebrate, and for everything that you guys have done for Right and Gray, we really appreciate it. And we continue to do great business with you guys. So cheers to King Darryl.
Tomorrow for our King's Royal Reign.
There you go. We're going to make it happen. No, we about to break the city, baby.
Y'all already know how we coming.
This is a prestige moment for me. I didn't know this was coming, but when they asked me, I said, whoa, man, this is royalty. Let me do this. Let's do it.
Tonight is a special night for Treme Sidewalk Steppers. My law partner, Darryl Gray, is the king this year. Which is something that is a tremendous honor for him as well as those in our firm.
Yeah, I've been knowing the King, as the other gentleman spoke, been knowing the King for a long time. He's like family. I've been knowing him over 20 years. Actually watch him grow into the person that he is at this point. Glad to be associated with him. Knew he's always gonna be successful. He's always been a guy that kind of gravitated to friends and family and show a lot of love and support. So. We here as a group to show him the same, you know, reciprocate that love and support back to him.
Met the guy like 4 or 5 years ago, and it's like, you know, the saying when they say when friends become family, dude is real solid and loyal, you know? So it's like, I know him about 4 or 5 years, but it's like I've been knowing him 20 years, man. That's how solid and loyal he is. Real guy, man, real stand-up guy, man.
You know, it's an honor. I've seen my dad overcome a lot of stuff, and just to see him get the praise that he deserves is everything for us, you know? A lot of family in town,
overseas and everything. So it's huge.
God bless America.
Oh, America. You know what I'm saying? Hey, God bless New Orleans.
Yeah.
7-1.
God bless New Orleans with 7-1, the 6-1, the 5th-1 surrounding areas.
The 9th-1, the whole New Orleans.
Coast. Because when Jermaine Sidewall Steppers come out, it's a big deal.
It's for the city.
It's for the city. And to be the king of the Sidewalk Steppers is a huge aside.
Man, bigger than Rex.
Yeah, bigger than Rex.
Representing the culture, baby.
Bigger right, than Rex right. For our folks, for real. Hey, bring man. The masses out.
Listen, it's a pleasure, privilege, and honor for us to be here, part of Darrell's Court, to be here as his friends, and all that good stuff. We're here to make sure that, one, we have a good time, represent him well, but it's about turning up.
And he spoke real proper.
hit him up with it, cuz. Hit him up with it, cuz.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Talk that stuff now, roll with it. Talk that stuff now, roll with it. Talk that stuff now, roll with it. Talk that stuff now, walking like a dog. Walking like a dog, walking like a dog, walking like a dog. What the, what the? Walking like a dog, walking like a dog.
I'm here for the celebration with the king and the queen. Darrell Gray is a friend of mine, and I'm excited about the opportunity to celebrate with he. And all of my family members that's part of the court. I think it's a great time and an outstanding opportunity to celebrate and have some fun.
Come to show love and support to the king, enjoy family and friends, and, you know, celebrating the culture.
I'm coming to this historic event that Mr. Darrell Gray is putting on with his court, and I happen to be part of the court for the community, you know, and what he's doing with our community. It's really what brought me here to be a part of this. Other than the camaraderie of brothers and, you know, all of those things that we need to have in our community to make it as a people.
Doing what you're doing, Big D, that's what I call it, Big D. Keep doing what he's doing for the people and what he's gonna do here. Continue to do what you do, and within this weekend, enjoy yourself to the fullest, because we don't know what the next time will bring.
Hey, you know what up? It's out. Say what's poppin'. Yeah. I don't fuck with these cause they shady. Deep, they just wanna have my baby. Born in the 80s, baby. Mama, she was in the street, so guess who raised me? You motherfucking right, couldn't get it from my mama, so I got it off the block. Been working my whole life, but I ain't never punched a clock. 9 years old, I seen them get shot. Damn. Quick to run they mouth when they get jammed. Third, tell it on his own fam. The same that you break your neck for.
Yeah.
Be the same that cross you out and wet you up. Supposed to be chasing money, but you chasing.
What you doing?
Real bosses don't talk, we just sit back and listen. Stack that paper up and then make boss moves.
Yeah.
She like to argue, so I sent that to law school.
Keep it real with your dog no matter what.
Preach. Same decline, she love you, she'll set you up.
Preach. Out here in these streets, it ain't no such thing as love.
Preach. The only thing I trust is this and these slugs.
Preach. Only when I do speak.
If that don't work, he'll fucking leech.
Preach. I ain't got shit for it. Ain't nothing in this motherfucking world free.
Preach. Zay got the mother face thump.
Your court just like came in here like you had the ballet, the violins and stuff. That's what I'm talking about. You be showing up. Look at the show. You chilling. That's what's up. It was great to meet you a few minutes ago, but hearing all the things that you do for the city is like amazing, and I can't wait to get to know you more, and I'm probably gonna need you to be my lawyer. So, what I'm saying is, congratulations, kid. Here you go.
Got the mother bass thumping. Dolph got the mother trap jumping. Doors to the trap open, now I sell you something.
You
hell no, nah, don't ask, I ain't fronting nothing.
Hell nah.
I f***ed your b***h and told her I see you around. Dolph just skipped town with 200,000. Dawg just pulled a in a 2 liter pop. They say Dawg addicted to these streets just like his pops. Addicted to hustling, I can't stop.
Won't stop.
Never hear me complain about what I ain't got. Cause if I want it, I'ma go get it. Yeah. Free my nigga, yo, did it. Got paper round tatted on your
empire.
Same, you getting high with, he really your enemy. Every day, cross they partners out for Benjamin.
Your
dog,
no matter what.
Same decline, she love you, she'll set you up.
Out here in these streets, it ain't no such thing as love.
Preach. The only thing I trust is this and these slugs.
Preach. Real only when I do speak.
If that don't work, he'll fucking leech.
Preach. I ain't got shit for it. Ain't nothing.
I'm most excited about the parade. Being a New Orleans police officer for 23 years, I'm always on the opposite end of the entertainment. So this year I get to ride on the float, get to look out and see hundreds of people.
What he's doing with our community is really what brought me here to be a part of this, because of the great things that he gives back to the community with the people and helping change lives. So that's what it's about for me. But I also come here to cut up like a motherfucker too, because I'm from uptown and that's what we do, baby.
It's one of the most treasured and most copied of our cultural traditions.
Love. That's all I can say. You gotta love it.
That's my outlet to know that I'm around family and I'm free.
You hear about second lines for just about anything these days, but make no mistake, for 10 months of the year and on any given Sunday. Neighborhoods across the city, social aid and pleasure clubs are putting on their annual parades.
That's our moment we get to shine throughout our community.
And in February, the 6th Ward has its own holiday. A Treme luxury experience, a tremendous cultural affair when Sidewalk takes over the streets. Its roots are distinctively African, but this cultural practice is indigenously New Orleans, tracing its origins as far back as Congo Square, where slaves and free people of color communed on Sundays.
We have to get the proper education on why we do this and not just come into this and just think that it's a party.
It's Black culture that's open to everyone. The irony here is it stems from a time when Blacks were not acknowledged as anyone in the Jim Crow South.
It was something we had to depend on because Black folks couldn't get insurance.
The Charbonnet Funeral Home has been in the heart of the Treme community for more than a century. And social aid and pleasure clubs we see now are versions of benevolent and mutual aid societies from back then.
They would take care of trying to help you to get into the hospital, to get medication, to see a doctor. A certain amount of money they would put aside for burials, $300, $600, and that would be a decent funeral at one point.
The parades were the earliest form of advertising.
The parades were just a celebration for them to say, well, we have a big membership now, and this is this. Take a look at our membership. And it would draw people to that organization.
We all out for fun. We're not out for trouble. We're not for having a good time for 4 hours. This is our celebration. When you get in a club and you parade, your 4 hours, that's your 4 hours. That's your 4 hours, you know, like in a movie.
While the clubs still do lots of community service, it is the parade that keeps everyone talking.
That Sunday, it's about us and the community. So we want to put on a show for our friends and our loved ones.
Well, you know, it's the clothes, the timing, the art, the music. It's the spirit.
It's the Ward culture. It often starts with remembering those who've passed. Then it's a jubilant celebration that takes a whole year to plan.
You come out with your beautiful clothes, well designed.
And all the matching accessories, elaborately woven baskets, briefcases for business as usual, sashes, and fans. It draws celebrities and even keeps city officials on their toes with stops at neighborhood businesses along the route. From footwork to feathers, it's a time to be lucid.
It's like rewarding, and then we spend like thousands of dollars to put on this show.
buck jumping, high stepping, laying in the streets, and climbing on the rooftop. The sidewalk culture you love is mainstream.
It's the heartbeat of our city, meaning not just sidewalk, all of us. Sunday is a very important day in New Orleans.
They can't shut TSS down. We're coming through.
Just being in amongst with people, just being in a parade, in the middle dancing, getting moved around when you're forced to dance. And like they say, if you ain't gonna dance, fuck on out the way. Thank you for thinking of me in this way of being part of your court, the royal court.
All right, everybody, it's a Treme holiday. The most tremendous day of my life. I'm about to live a New Orleans girl dream. I'm the 2023 queen for the Sidewalk Steppers Treme, and I'm honored and I'm so excited about today.
671 holiday.
What's up, baby? What's up? Ready to do this damn thing, baby. Sidewalk Stepper, let's do it.
You're gonna break it down, baby. Ready to go right now.
Let's get the king and the queen. Yeah.
That's for the queen?
Yeah, this for the queen right here.
Something light.
Wing. Tree
up. We know what to do. Man, play no games. Play no games. My father, like my big brother Bob said, a win for me is a win for you.
Ah, you got that relative look.
Man, this shit feel like... Man, it look like a black James.
I'm not going.
Behind this piece is to show tradition of the sidewalk steppers, so the tradition of our area here in the Treme, tradition of our king, who's a strong black man in our community and a pillar in our community, along with he and his firm, keep the tradition of New Orleans alive and well. It's an inspiration for others to know they can come up and do the same thing that he's done.
Checkmate, baby.
Yeah, checkmate all three, y'all. One, two, three.
That's the motto for the year.
How's everything with you today?
Everything is great. You look fabulous.
Thank you so much. As you can see, it's another fun-filled Sunday.
Yes, sir.
People are out again, enjoying themselves and having a good time. Treme Sidewalk Steppers, one of the premier parades here in New Orleans. Everybody is out and about, and there's only maybe just a few people out here right now, but I guarantee it's going to get even larger. So we look forward to seeing y'all come out, enjoy, and have a great time. There's a lot of love out here.
Motherfucking priest. You understand me?
Go sit on that bag.
Understand what natural life, love, environment, people, everything.
Universally ordained, man. That's how we rolling, man. We connected to the Most High.
Yeah, to the stars, baby.
I'm telling you, the sky, the moon, the soil, the water is all here together.
That's right.
You see it all here. You see the colors. You see the elements. We got you.
Earth tones. Got the gold, especially the gold running through there. That's protect from that radiation and all that shit.
We came to put something powerful up into the atmosphere, man. That's what we're about to do. Something serious, man. Ashe.
We got our people. We got our people with us right here, brother.
Oh, man. Brother.
Brother.
He's rolling with me.
You got to bow down to them.
Coming in to do this thing to Ukraine and Russia.
They call him the oldest. They call him the oldest, but the goodie.
Hello.
Hello.
Good evening.
Hey, everybody. So we are... in Treme today with the Queen and Queen 2023 Sidewalk Steppers, Mr. Darrell A. Gray and Treva Williams. Y'all stay tuned because this is only the beginning. I told y'all it's about to be like a movie. Don't believe me, just watch. You got the night with me. Come on and roll with me.
Sidewalk Steppers. You better believe it, baby. The turn of the wheel. We out here, baby. 2023. Number pressure.
Gray all day. We're not going to play with it. Day off top.
Y'all can't stop the sidewalk. Y'all been through that part, though. We're going to take another.
Sidewalk Sunday. Everybody looking beautiful. Everybody's on point. $1 million in a briefcase. That's what it is. It's unlocking at the end of the day. So if you around, be in town, because it's $1 million getting splashed all around.
Best thing you can see for free. Hey.